My name is Nikita Tiwari, and today we'll be seeing the number representation. So basically, there are two types of number representations available in the digital logic, that is fixed point representation and floating point representation. So in the fixed point representation, we have fixed number of digits after the decimal part. That is, it is already fixed that how many digits will be in the integer part and how many will be in the decimal part. And in the floating point representation, this is also known as scientific notation of the number representation. And here we have exponent, magnitude, and radix. Okay, so we will be seeing both of these representations one by one. So basically, in the fixed point representation, as I have already explained, that the digits after the decimal will be fixed. So let's see this with an example. And also in the fixed point representations, there will be two type of representation, that is first one unsigned fixed point number, and second one will be signed fixed point number. In the unsigned, we'll be just handling the positive numbers, and while in the signed fixed point numbers, we will be handling the negative values also. So let's see them one by one. So here we have taken an example that represent fixed point representation of unsigned binary number 0110100 using 4 integer bits and 3 fractional bits and represent in its decimal equivalent. So first we have to represent this given number in the fixed point number, that, and the condition given is that we have to take 4 integer bits and 3 fractional bits, and then we have to convert the same into its decimal equivalent. So first let's start with the fixed point number representation, then we will see the conversion. So as given in the question, we have to take 4 integer bits, that is before integer we will have 4 bits and after decimal we will have 3 bits. So according to our question, this will be the fixed point number representation of this. And next it is saying that we have to convert it into the decimal equivalent. So we have already seen the binary to decimal equivalent, and we do this conversion like this, that first we will convert the integer part and then we will convert the decimal part. So we have to start taking from 2 to the power 0. This bit is 0, so we will take 0 here. Plus, next we will take 2 to the power 1 multiplied by, as this bit is 1, so we will be writing 1 here. Next, we have to take 2 to the power 2 multiplied 1 as this bit is 1. And then next, we have to take 2 to the power 3 multiplied by 0. And as there are only 4 bits, so we don't have to go further. We will stop on 2 to the power 3. Let's calculate it. So this will be the 0. Plus, this will be 2, plus 2 to the power 2 will be the 4 multiplied by 1. It will remain 4 only, and this will be 0. So the integer part we have got is 6. Now we will solve the decimal part separately. So we have already seen this, that how do we convert a decimal part of the binary to its decimal equivalent. So here we will take, as this bit is 1, so 1 into 2 to the power minus 1 plus 0 into 2 to the power minus 2 plus 0 into 2 to the power minus 3. As these bits are 0 and 2 to the power minus 1 will be 0.5, so 1 multiplied by 0.5, we will get 0.5 only. So the complete conversion of 0110.100 in decimal equivalent, this is in the binary, and its decimal equivalent will be 6.5, and that will be in the base 10. Now let's move to the sign fixed point numbers. So as sign is included here, that is number can be positive and negative as well in this. So to represent the negative numbers, we have two methods, that is two's complement and sign and magnitude notation. So mostly in the computer system, two's complement is followed. So we'll be seeing this method with the help of two's complement only, as we have already learned this. So our example is represent minus 5.5 base 10, that is this number is in the decimal form, using 8-bit binary representation with 4-digit integer and 4 fraction bit. So we have to represent minus 5.5 base 10 into the fixed point representation, and the condition given is 4-digit integer and 4 fraction bit. So let's first convert this. As of now, for we just take the value 5.5 only. We will handle this negative later on. First convert this into the binary equivalent. So we know that we write this 5 in the binary as 101, and next we have to convert the this decimal point 5 into the binary. So its method is we have to multiply it by 2, so we will get 1.0. we will get 1 as our answer, and then we have to multiply 0, so we will be getting 0 only afterwards. So we can write just 1 here. So this is the binary equivalent of 5.5. but here the condition given is that we have to represent this number into the 8-bit binary. So we need to complete the missing bits, that is we will add 0 here so that our notation gets into the 8-bit, and we will add 3 zeros after this 1. So now you can see that this is the 8-bit representation of this decimal number. Now our conversion into the binary is completed. Next we have to see that how we will represent this minus. So as I have already explained that the negative values in the digital logic system are being implemented mostly by using the 2's complement. So by taking the 2's complement of this number, we will get the minus 5.5 equivalent in the binary form. So let's do this. And how do we do that? We just get first 1's complement first, and then we add plus 1 to that to get the 2's complement. So here the 0 bit will become 1 0 1 0 0.0111, right? Now what we have to do, we have to add plus 1 in it. So 1 plus 1 will be 0 with carry 1, again 1 plus 1 will be 0 with carry 1, 0 with carry 1, 0 plus 1 will be 1, and the rest of the bits will remain same. So this is the fixed point representation of minus 5.5 into its binary equivalent. In the next video, we will be seeing the floating point representation of the numbers. So this is it for this video. Thank you.